guys. So we are gonna be doing a pour on a 16 by 40 inch canvas. I have various colors of blues and greens. A lot of them are personal mixes, but at the end of this video or somewhere at the end of the video, it'll show the paints that I used. I really could not tell you what ratio I used either. But I did mix them with, all of the paints were mixed with Liquitex Pouring Medium. And they are fairly thin, so they're very drizzly, almost like the consistency of water. So, anywho, so check out the end of the video for the paint colors that I'm using. I'm using a new color today and I absolutely love it. I wish the color would come out better on screen, but I don't think it's going to. I have a light out behind me, so maybe that's causing some discoloring in the video, but it's a beautiful dark periwinkle. And yeah, so if we could go for it and see how it does. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to layer up a couple of cups with all of these colors. I have my Artist Loft white, but I also have a iridescent pearl white by Golden Fluid Acrylics. And we're going to see what we can create. I want something calming, and that's about where I'm at. This, I think, is going to be more of like a dirty pour. As the paints are so thin, I'm not sure if they will really be able to layer on top of each other. So I'm just going ahead. I have no rhyme or reason for my coloring. I'm just putting them in. I've got some Payne's Gray, Bright Aqua Green, and I just got some on the canvas. This is gonna be a little tougher than I thought. Do the Bright Aqua Green. Of course, I didn't think they'd layer very well, but they're doing okay. Some paints are heavier than others, so. So this is going to be one of those paintings that I'll never be able to recreate again. So, you know, have fun while we can. This beautiful color I'm really excited about using. The cup is really amazing. The colors that are coming up are really, really cool. One, and let's do another, because why not do a few cups because this is a fairly large canvas. Have the aquamarine by Treasure Gold, and I had put it in there a few moments ago, and the cells came right up, which were exciting to see. There's no silicone used at all in this pour. Very excited. Put these over to the side for a minute. I think I'm just gonna work with those cups for now. If I need another cup, I'll make another one, but we wanna make sure we have some leftover paints as we go. So I'm gonna clean all this up and I'll be back with you in just a moment. Okay, so here we are. I'm wondering if you guys can see beautiful shimmer in the cup. Again, no silicone. I started off layering unknowingly and more like a dirty pour after that. So here is our canvas. Again, this is a 16 by 40. I'm just gonna put some white down. If I need another cup, I'll just layer this cup. All right. Okay, put that cup on over there. I'm loving this. This is so pretty.
some movement in there. Area is so pretty. All right, so just in case you're wondering, that did not go on the floor. There is a pad there that was put there on purpose to catch any runoff. Really liking this. I'm not crazy about this area, but we're gonna keep moving. My cup. All right. I think these lines are a little too jagged, so I'm going to do another pour so that I can get these corners as well. I get them all the way. Very thin paint, but I wanted that. I wanted it to be thin. All right, so I'm just gonna come in here and fix a little something. There you go. I crushed my cup, so it wasn't cooperating as much. There we go. I always have backup. Now here, let's are sticking to the paper towel I put on there. And top it off with that. And that's it. Side. These canvases are heavy once the paint gets on there, so these fabulous cups start collapsing. Think I'll leave it just as is.
Yeah, we'll go this way a little bit.
Are a mess. I'm loving the runoff because I can utilize it. Okay, so I think that's gonna be it. I'm gonna bring you guys in just a minute to take a look at the final piece.